This module deals with how to name coordination compounds, nomenclature. So first, when you're naming a coordination compound, you say the name of the cation first and then the name of the anions. Now, sometimes the cation can be a metal ion, sometimes it can be the complex ion. So for here, in this compound here, the cation is potassium, it's written first. By the way, just like in ionic compounds, the cation is written first and the anion second. So the potassium is a cation, we start the name with the word potassium. Here, because the complex ion is written first, we know it's the cation, so we would say its name first. Now we'll see why this is in a minute, but it ends up that the name of this complex ion is tetraamine cobalt 1. So that's how the name of this compound would start out. Within the complex ion, you say the names of the ligands in alphabetical order, and then you say the name of the metal ion. So the ligands come first, then the metal ion. So in this complex ion here, the ligands are, there's four amines. So we say tetraamine cobalt 1. Here are the names of some common ligands. Here, we'll look at these in a minute. If the ligand is an anion, its name's going to end in O. If it's a neutral compound, the ligand that is, then it's going to have a lot of times the same name as the molecule. So let's look here. All of these ligands have negative charges. They all end in O. Bromo, chloro, cyano, hydroxo, oxo, carbonato, nitro, oxalato. And then the neutral ones, well, ammonia is called amine, carbon monoxide is called carbonyl water, so aqua. But ethylene diamine is called that ethylene diamine, and ethylene diamine tetraacetate is called ethylene diamine tetraacetate, or EDTA and EN. So if you have two or more ligands, then you use the Greek prefixes di, tri, tetra, penta, and hexa to say how many there are. For example, here there are four amines, two chloro, so we would say tetraamine dichloro, and then we say the name of the metal, cobalt 3. If the ligand already has a Greek prefix in it, like ethylene diamine, di does, then we use a different set of prefixes. Bis for 2, tris for 3, and tetracris for 4. So here, we have three ethylene diamines. We would call this complex ion tris for 3, ethylene diamine cobalt 3. You always say the name, or rather the oxidation state of the metal in Roman numerals, in parentheses right after the name of the metal, just like we did in ionic compounds. So here we would have tetraamine dichloro chromium 3. It's chromium 3 because each of the chlorides we know is a negative 1. There's an overall plus 1 charge, so two negatives, this has to be a positive 3. There's no charge on the ammonias. If the complex ion is an anion, then its name is going to end in A-T-E. So here, this would be called, because it's an anion, be called hexacyanoferrate 2. Again, the Roman numeral 2, because there are six negative charges from the cyanides, overall four negative charges, that means there must be a plus 2 on the iron. These are the names of some of the metals in anionic compounds, complexes, ending in A-T-E, so aluminate, chromate, cobaltate. But we use the older names for some of these metals, like cuprate for copper, and orate for gold, and ferrate for iron, plumbate for lead, manganate, molybdate, nickelate, arginate for silver, stannate for tin, tungstate, and zincate. So let's try to apply this. So why don't you pause this for a minute and see if you can name these two compounds. All right, ready? So this one is called, say the name of the cation first, it's potassium, say potassium, hexacyanoferrate 3. 3 because there's 3 positive charges from the potassiums, 6 negative charges from the cyanide, so there must be 3 positive charges on the iron. This one is called dichloro, bisethylene diamine. Chloro comes first because alphabetically it comes before ethylene diamine. Bis because there's the di in the diamine. So dichlorobisethylene diamine, chromium 3 bromide. Chromium 3, again, because there's two negative charges from the chlorides, one from the bromide, that makes it a positive 3. All right, so now why don't you take these names and see if you can figure out the formulas? Pause it and do it, and here we go. So penta aqua, bromo ruthenium 2 nitrate. Penta is 5, aqua is water, so 5 waters. Bromo is bromine, ruthenium nitrate. The plus 2 on the ruthenium, there's no charges on the waters, there's a negative 1 on the bromide, so that means there must be one of the nitrates. Plus 2, negative 1, has to be 1, negative 1 here. Sodium hexanitro cobaltate 3. So sodium is first. Hexanitro, 6 nitrites, each with a negative 1. Cobaltate 3, so there's cobalt with a 3 positive charge, 6 negatives here. That means there must be 3 sodiums, each with a plus 1 charge to balance it out.